So I'm here with Sara Alsherif, and you're an MA student at the University of Sussex. Sara, and we're going to be talking about LGBT rights in Egypt, and I know that you're aiming to mark the passing of one of your friends who was an LGBT activist, and you're going to mark it by doing a mural, aren't you, in the centre of our town. So maybe just start off with about the case in Egypt and your friend.
Yeah, my friend's called Sarah Hegazi, and she is an LGBT human rights activist, and she has been arrested in Egypt in 2017 for waving a rainbow flag in a concert in Cairo. And after that, and after her photo circulated over the internet and all the website while she's cheering, waving the flag in the concert, the police security arrested her with 50 people for waving a rainbow flag in the concert. And Sarah, while she is in prison, she spent 3 months there, and she had been tortured and sexual harassment, and she went out after 3 months with a trauma. It was safe to her to go out the country because security keep following her, controlling her contacts and monitoring and watching her Facebook accounts and her social media. After she went to the jail, she fired from her job, her family abandoned her, her friends abandoned her, so she was so depressed. She went to Canada after a while. And while she in Canada, she really were missing her country and her family and her mother. Her mother passed out and died while she is in self-exile in Canada. She committed suicide in June 14, 2020. This year, last month, and this was so sad, and this was a reaction, and because all she suffered in Egypt, we decided to do a mural for her, for remembering her, and to give her, she is someone who I see that she has been killed. Because just yes, it's she committed suicide, but it's as a result of it. She had been tortured for just waving a flag.
Yeah,
it's so dramatically that just waving a rainbow flag to face all this stuff for just coming out with your sexual orientation or your gender identity. So it wasn't fair.
Yeah, and it's not uncommon, is it, that people get abused in Egypt because they don't have a great track record, do they, on recognising LGBT plus rights?
Yeah, it's common that the LGBT people who coming out or talking about their identity, sexual orientation or identity, to get arrested or abusing or trolling over the social media. Authority had been arrested 232 people over 5 years because of the LGBTQ rights and their activists, and police security targeting people who using Grindr application, and they trying to make a fake account on Grindr to arresting them and making a trap.
Yeah.
There is a decree. Over the media for banning any positive portraying the gay or lesbian or trans signs, and they identifying the homosexuality as a sickness.
Yeah, I'm coming back to the city mural. I know you can't reveal the location yet, but what are you aiming to depict in the mural? What kind of messages?
Yes, the messages, it will be something for Sarah, it will be a model for all the struggles and all what people suffering in Egypt and the LGBT groups and society and queers group situation in Egypt, because these people is under attack really, and they're suffering more because whether on the social level from their families and friends or and from acceptance and from and over the political situation too. If you, it's not easy to come out. You will face maybe jail. I couldn't forget that when I changed my profile picture on Facebook to after Sarah died, I changed my profile picture to a rainbow flag. I got a lot of threatening message over my inbox, Facebook inbox,
yeah.
Threatings and trolling and people insulted me for just changing my profile picture, and these people, they didn't know me. Imagine what Sarah suffering after she waving the flag publicly in concert. And it's not to mention that this concert and the Lebanese band now who made this concert is banned now from doing any concert anymore in Egypt for what happened there.
Yeah.
So it's so sad all what happened there.
Yeah, and what just before we go, what can be done to kind of improve the situation in these countries? I guess I'm guessing like education. People always mention that better education, but what about awareness as well?
Yes, it's.
I know that a lot of Western countries are big aid donors to Egypt, aren't they? Including
yes.
The US and the UK. So maybe that's one area.
Yes, it's.
Where we can use a bit of leverage.
It's very important to highlight this aspect because the UK and USA supporting Egypt politically in many issues, and while they supporting it, Egypt violating many human rights principles, and I think this is good to make a cooperation on enhancing the situation of LGBT rights in Egypt, especially that UK and US supporting the government with the technology that enabling them to identify and following people over the internet and arresting them.
Yeah.
So it's a matter of strengthening the government against these people. So it will be good to work against that and to raise an awareness about these issues and raise this subject with the Egyptian government.
Yeah, okay. And the mural is going to be up around the 5th of September,
yeah,
is that right?
Yes, it will be up around...
Somewhere in the centre of the city?
Yes, yeah. Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Thanks for coming in again, Sarah, and all the best with the mural.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you.
Cheers,
thank you, Mark. Yeah, thank you.